Hello children, welcome to AIIMS India's online classes, biology session, cell division and cell cycle, part 3. In the part 2, we discussed about metaphase, anaphase, telophase of mitosis cell division and cytokinesis and significance of mitosis. Mitosis is also called equational cell division. The two daughter cells which are formed by the end of mitosis will exactly resemble their parent cells. Okay. So, and some more significance of mitosis division and about the meiosis we are going to discuss in this video. So, meiosis, if you take so mitosis helps in the wound healing and the replacement of old and worn out cells. It helps in the growth, the embryonic growth takes place by mitosis. Unicellular organisms also divide by a kind of mitosis division. Okay. So, but the meiosis division, it is unique, it is different, it is most important. It is a unique type of cell division. It is necessary for sexual reproduction in eukaryotic organisms for the formation of gametes. Meiosis is a specialized kind of cell division. Why? Because it reduces the chromosome number by half, which results in the production of haploid daughter cells, nothing but gametes. It ensures the production of haploid phase in the life cycle of sexually reproducing organisms, whereas the fertilization restores the diploid phase. So, before formation of zygote, meiosis plays an important role for the production of gametes. After fertilization, the zygote divides by mitosis and the cell division continues and cell differentiation and the organism is formed. So, the crucial role is played by this meiosis division. Okay. The meiosis involves two sequential cycles of nuclear and cell divisions. Okay, the cells that are produced by the process of meiosis are referred to as gametes or spores. Okay. Or reproductive cells. Meiosis shuffles the genes between the chromosomes in a pair, which are received from the each parent. So that's why genetic recombination takes place in this division. Crossing over of chromosomes takes place in the meiotic division. What is crossing over? Nothing but shuffling of the genes between the chromosomes in a pair. In a pair means two chromosomes, one from parents, one from male and one from female parents. Okay, which are received from the each parent. It produces the chromosomes with new genetic combinations. It produces the chromosomes with new genetic combinations in every gamete the process generates. Meiosis division produces genetically unique four daughter cells are formed here. The chromosome number is half as that is in the parent cell. Okay, if the parent cell is diploid, the daughter cells are haploid, exactly half. Okay, that's why meiosis division is a unique cell division. Okay, next, let us go into details of the meiosis. So here what happened means it involves the two sequential cycles of the nuclear and cell division, which is called meiosis 1 and meiosis 2. okay, but only a single cycle of DNA replication occur. Interface occurs only one time. It involves the pairing of homologous chromosomes and the recombination between them, and it provides opportunities for the new combination of genes to occur in the gametes by two ways. Okay, here the laws of genetics are also involved here. So law of independent assortment of chromosomes takes place in the meiosis, and crossing over takes place in the meiosis. The chromosomal and gene mutations can take place by irregularities of meiotic divisions. Okay, so here briefly the first going into details chart is given here. If you go through the chart, so leave this interface. Actually this interface occur after meiosis 1. The meiosis can be studied under two headings, meiosis 1 and meiosis 2. Okay, means the karyokinesis occur twice in the meiosis, whereas in the mitosis only one nuclear division occur, but here two nuclear divisions occur. The meiosis 2 is similar to that of mitosis only, but meiosis 1 only very lengthy and you need to understand. Okay, so meiosis 1 starts with the meiosis 1, if you take it is called the reductional division. Actually meiosis 1 is called reductional division. Meiosis 2 is also called again equational division, which is similar to mitosis. In the meiosis 1, it is also called heterotypic division because it brings about change from diploid to haploid state. From diploid to haploid state. So here it is divided into four subphases. In the mitosis we come across only prophase, metaphase, anaphase, telophase. But here prophase 1, metaphase 1, anaphase 1, telophase 1, like that. And next in the meiosis 2, prophase 2, metaphase 2, anaphase 2, telophase 2. So in between this meiosis 1 and meiosis 2, this interface is present. Okay, here in the interface main change occur chromosome duplication, doubling of chromosomes takes place. So in the meiosis 1, haploid daughter cells are formed, four daughter cells with haploid chromosomes, so they get doubled in the interface. Again in the meiosis 2, daughter cells are formed with haploid chromosomes. Okay, so this will happen. So in the prophase 1, here what happens in the prophase 1, homologous chromosomes pair and the exchange segments takes place. In the metaphase 1, tetrad lineup is formed, tetrads are formed, means equatorial plate only, but here tetrad we are calling it as. So centrosome or centromere with kinetochore is formed, we call it as tetrads. Then in anaphase 1, the homologous chromosomes separate from each other, reach the opposite poles, the pair of homologous chromosomes split up. Here this tetrad will split and the daughter chromosomes are formed, or we can call it as sister chromatids, they get remained attached to the spindle. Okay, so prophase 1, it is the longest and the complex divided, the complex phase. This prophase 1 is again divided into 5 stages: leptotene, zygotene, pachytene, diplotene and diakinesis. There are 5 subphases are there in the prophase 1. That's why it is the longest phase in the meiosis. Then metaphase 1. In the metaphase 1, what happened? Arrangement of chromosomes at equatorial plate or equator. The maximum condensation of chromosomes takes place. Then in the anaphase 1, movement of homologous chromosomes. In the anaphase, movement of homologous without centromere breakage occur here. The next, in telophase 1, chromosomes elongate, the formation of two haploid cells takes place. Okay, so let us see about meiosis 1. Okay, so lot of importance is given to the meiosis cell division. So understand, very easy to understand, follow. The meiosis 1, it has four subphases. What are they? Prophase 1, metaphase 1, anaphase 1 and telophase 1. This is the first nuclear division. The meiosis, nucleus divides twice, I said no. The first nuclear division is named as meiosis 1. The meiosis 1 can be divided into prophase 1, metaphase 1, anaphase 1 and telophase 1. First, prophase 1. Prophase 1 is again, for clear understanding, it has five subphases. What are they? Leptotene, zygotene, pachytene, diplotene and diakinesis. First, leptotene. The leptotene, nucleus enlarges in size. What are the changes occur? So nucleus enlarges in size, long chromosomes, and the chromosomes show bouquet arrangement. The chromatids are seen, and which are helpful in identifying the chromosomes. Bouquet stage, this is. Bouquet means bunch of chromosomes. The homologous paternal means parent, fathers, and maternal means mother's chromosomes come close together by a point. Close together at a point or appears. So this is a bouquet stage. That's why it is called. Just like in a bouquet, all the flower, bunch of flowers will form a bouquet. Okay? So that's why it is called a bouquet stage. Leptotene. The chromosomes with the centrioles and the centromere, it appears. Nucleus enlarges in size. See, the nucleus size is very big. Okay. And the chromatids are seen. So these are the chromatids, which are helpful in identifying the chromosome. Next. Our formation of chromosomes takes place during the leptotene. Next, in the prophase 1, second substage is zygotene. What is zygotene? Bivalents are formed, means pair of homologous chromosomes are formed. They are called bivalents. Bi means two, pair. Pair of homologous chromosomes. Homologous chromosomes means which are similar in structure are formed. The pairing of homologous chromosomes takes place. Pairing of homologous paternal and maternal, fathers and mothers chromosomes. It is called synapsis. It is called synapsis. Means pairing of homologous paternal and maternal chromosomes is called synapsis. Synapsis is of three types. Such as proterminal, pairing starts at the ends. Procentric, pairing starts at the centromere, means center of the chromosome. And random or intermediate, means pairing occurs at various places. It may be of any type, proterminal or procentric or intermediate type of. Totally, pairing of chromosomes takes place during the zygotene. See, synaptonemal complex is formed after pairing or during the pairing. Synaptonemal complex, like this, the pairing of chromosomes takes place. Maternal and paternal. So zygotene. Nucleolus enlarges and the spindle formation is initiated. Nucleolus enlarge and the spindle formation initiates. So during the zygotene, what happens means chromosomes become shorter and thicker. Bivalents or tetrad paired homologous chromosomes are seen. So these are called tetrads. Okay. Synapsis or syndesis pairing of chromosomes occur. Then the bivalents form synaptonemal complexes. So bivalents will form what? Synaptonemal complex. Synaptonemal complex. Complexes. Why it is formed? To stabilize paired condition of chromosomes. To stabilize the paired conditions of chromosomes, condition of chromosome, synaptonemal complexes are formed. Okay, children. Let us proceed to the third substage of prophase 1. Okay. Pactin. Pactin. It is the third. The four chromatids are seen in a bivalent. In a bivalent, four chromatids are seen. The pactin tetrads are formed. Chiasma formation. Their synaptonemal complex is formed. Here chiasma. What is chiasma means? The points where the two non-chromatids contact and subsequently exchange their parts. It is called chiasma. Chiasma formation occurs in which stage of the meiosis 1? That is in the prophase 1, in pactin stage. At chiasma, chromosomes appear as X shape. Chromosomes attain the shape of an alphabetical letter X shape structure. Then crossing over also takes place. Crossing over means the exchange of genetic materials between the two non-sister chromatids takes place. It is called crossing over. Crossing over results in recombination of characters. So pactin stage, so many changes, so many important events are taking place. Chiasma formation, crossing over. This crossing over results in the recombination of characters. Then crossing over is responsible for the origin of new species leading to evolution. Because of this crossing over only, the new characters, hybrid characters are produced in the offsprings. Okay. Then last, breakage of chromatids at chiasma and get united by an enzyme called ligase. Okay. So here, synaptonemal complex will lead to the formation of tetrads. These tetrads will undergo the chiasma formation. During this chiasma formation, the two non-sister chromatids contact and exchange their parts, during which they attain the shape of X, the letter of X, okay, capital letter X shape. Then the crossing over takes place. Okay, the crossing over results in the recombination of characters. So what are the changes takes place in the pactin stage? It is also a longest stage because it takes time to crossover. So tetrad. So here this is the tetrad. The tetrad clearly appears as spirally arranged chromosomes of homologous pair. Crossing over means recombination occurs. This stage is characterized by the appearance of recombination nodule. Okay, involves mutual exchange of the corresponding segments of non-sister chromatids of homologous chromosomes. The exchange of genetic material takes place. Pairing of chromosomes occur, attain the X shape. That X shape, it is attained. Okay, after attaining that, the crossing over occurs. So this is the pactin stage. Next, the fourth substage of the prophase 1, diplotene, a stage of meiotic prophase which follows the pacotene, and during which the paired homologous chromosomes begin to separate and the cache matter become visible. The synaptonemal complexes loosen, and the partial separation of each pair of sister chromatids from their homologous counterparts occur. Okay, previously in the pacotene stage, and the zygotene stage, synaptonemal complexes are formed. Okay, in the pacotene stage, chiasma formation takes place. So they are all visible here once again. Means they are loosened. Those complexes, they are very tight, where the exchange of genetic material takes place between the homologous chromosomes of non-sister chromatids. Okay, takes place. That is called crossing over. Okay, after that, here again the synaptonemal complexes are loosened, and the partial separation of each pair of sister chromatids from their homologous counterparts occur. Okay, like this, they are separated. So here chiasma is clearly visible here, where they are attached. So these are two different non-sister chromatids, so they are getting separated. Chiasma is visible here. Okay, after crossing over, the chromosomes attain which shape? X shape. So next, the chromatids are still held together at the centromere and the sites of crossing over. The dictyotene stage, or the diplotene stage, is the resting phase of the oocyte. Okay, it is the resting phase of oocyte. Oocyte means egg cell. So here the centromere, the chiasma clearly visible. So here in the diplotene, bivalent repel each other, means somewhat separating from each other. Chiasmata or sister, the sites of crossing over points strongly appeared. You can clearly see. In oocytes of some vertebrates, it can last for months. So oocytes means egg. So that's why this last point is exceptional. The diplotene stage, is a resting phase in some vertebrates, in the oocytes, several months it may take. Okay, next, the next one is the last one, diakinesis. Okay, the prophase 1 is divided into 5 subphases. What are they? Leptotene, zygotene, pacotene, diplotene, now diakinesis. Diakinesis is the last stage in the prophase 1. In the diakinesis, the final stage in the first meiotic prophase, in gametogenesis, means formation of gametes, in which the chromosomes achieve their maximum thickness. The chiasmata and the nucleolus disappear. Chiasmata and nucleolus, which are clearly appear during the diplotene, now they start disappear and degenerates. And the spindle fibers form in preparation for the formation of dyads. Okay, now tetrads are converted to dyads. Like this. The spindle fibers start appearing. The chiasmata start disappearing. Nucleolus also start disappearing. Centromere is clearly visible. So during this diakinesis, the 4N means tetrad. Diakinesis, RNA synthesis stops. Chromatids become visible. The homologous chromosomes linked at chiasma. the crossing over takes place in this Kashmir region. The chromatids linked at chromosome, the centromere is visible. Okay, so here the chromosomes become fully condensed and the nuclear membrane disintegrates prior to metaphase 1. Okay, nuclear membrane disintegrates, totally disappear. So actually during prophase what happened means nuclear membrane start disappearing, the decondensation of chromosomes takes place. Okay, and the chromatin material takes place, the chromosomes will be formed and the spindle fiber start forming. Okay, centrosome breaks and centrioles release, all these are the changes takes place during the prophase. The similar changes are taking place in the mitosis as well as in the meiosis, but the meiosis, in order to understand clearly, so it is the longest phase in the meiotic division, that is prophase 1. Okay, so here what happened during diakinesis, terminalization occurs, means the terminal chiasma slips off and ends of the chromosomes and its position is taken by an interstitial chiasma. Okay, or we can say the nuclear membrane disappears, centrioles migrate to the poles and the spindle fiber begin to form. Okay, the centromeres go to opposite poles. The centrosome with the centrioles break and the centrioles, so this one is centriole. The two centrioles go to the opposite poles of the nucleus and they start producing the spindle fiber because chromosomes are formed. Okay, they start moving from place to place. So in the metaphase 1 what happens, we will see in the next class. Okay, thank you for watching our video. Please subscribe our channel and press the bell icon for receiving latest updates.